Hey, welcome back. Dr. Matt here. So today we're talking about the trifecta of iron deficiency. So say you are a female who is menstruating, one, you're vegetarian, two, and you're a regular runner, have a regular running routine, number three. When you put this combo together, it is really challenging not to end up in an iron deficient state. And in my experience, your iron deficiency symptoms, you know, they won't just show up at your door one day. Right away, oh my goodness, I started running, I became vegan, next day I'm iron deficient. No, it starts up very slowly, and you know, often when people go vegan, become vegetarian, it can be 2 to 3 years before symptoms actually fully manifest. But I can assure you, unless you're one of those, you know, one in a million outliers, you are living in an iron deficiency state. In a female, blood is being lost via menstruation, you know, month after month after month. And then running, losing more blood, you know, that hemolysis that happens with each foot, time your foot hits the ground, and it's just not being recouped sufficiently via a vegan food routine. And there's just not enough iron there. And this isn't a knock on a vegan or vegetarian lifestyle or food routine. This is simply biology. This is simply digestion. This is simply absorption capacity and our, you know, the digestive tract's ability to extract iron from these vegetarian foods. There's not the machinery necessary to get what the body needs from the vegetarian lifestyle. This matters because most people who are embarking on a vegetarian food routine are doing so with hopes of improving their health status, with hopes of, wow, if I'm getting all these colors, these phytochemically dense foods, like I'm gonna be healthier, I'm gonna run faster, run longer, which there are a lot of truths to that. However, when the body is deficient in iron, energy systems of the body turn down. Immune function is compromised, pregnancy complications increase, cognitive abilities are impaired. And for the athlete, you know, stress in the heart muscle, stress on the skeletal muscle, on the whole circulatory system is increased. Not to mention, you know, just the likelihood of getting injured because the repair and recovery process is not where it needs to be. It is not optimal. So that leaves, I would say, a vegan or vegetarian, you know, behind, you are behind, and you're creating, you know, in your desire to get healthy, you're actually creating ill health, because none of that sounds like improved health and vitality, right? So if you're a menstruating female, you're already likely behind when it comes to iron intake and recouping iron and having iron stores available for use. So you want to make extra conscious effort actions to ensure you are getting enough iron, either in your food routine or supplementally, as well as, you know, you're getting your iron levels checked at least on an annual basis if you're a menstruating woman. If you're a runner, you know, on top of that, on top of being a menstruating woman, it becomes doubly important to ensure, you know, an iron-rich food routine and knowing where your ferritin, where your iron saturation level is at. So I hope this is gonna help you. And over, I've seen patients who started bonking in life, started bonking in the performance, you know, on a vegan or vegetarian food routine. And they get their iron levels up and voila, oh my goodness, which leads them to reevaluating why they were choosing their vegan or vegetarian lifestyle in the first place. The thing is, we want our food lifestyle to lead to more health, more vitality, more vigor. And if our food lifestyle is not leading to more health, more vitality, more vigor, more energy, you know, more motivation, more giddy up, let's go, I would suggest you want to reevaluate that, because we don't want to shut down menstruation via birth control. Bad idea. Another video coming on that. And I don't want you to stop running, because running's fantastic. Working out's fantastic. Sweating's fantastic. The thing we can do, though, is we can always adjust that food routine to better help us meet the nutrient needs of our body. All right, I'm Dr. Matt. Hope this is helpful. Let me know how veganism, vegetarianism has worked for you, not worked for you, and what you've done to, you know, refurbish your iron stores if you found yourself in a place of iron deficiency.